Dear friends, now we will be talking about one of the important topic in a supply chain management. But before we jump into the topic, let's understand two examples to relate to the topic. So first example is, if we want to buy a car, then we have multiple criteria to compare different cars. Like we have boot space, we have engine capacity, we have mileage of the car, we have seating capacity and more. Let's take another example. If we have to buy a computer system, then we have multiple criteria to select from different computer systems like storage capacity, RAM capacity, then we have screen size, we have operating system. So these are different aspects that we do compare when we have to take some decisions. Now, what about supply chain? Do we have some reference models which can help us to benchmark our company's supply chain or processes and also metrics to know how better we are doing across the industry? And answer to this is yes. There are several models worldwide, and one of the prominent models and well-known model is a SCOR model. So in this topic, we will talk about the SCOR models. And if you see, this topic is more important for supply chain professionals who are working in leadership position and also positions where strategic decision-making roles are actually required. So agenda for today's topic is, we'll understand what is SCOR model, the definition of SCOR model, then SCOR model and its characteristics. Then we will talk about different processes in the SCOR model. Then we will also talk about some KPI, that is key performance indicators, that are being measured with this model. Then we will also talk about advantages and disadvantages of this model. And lastly, we will talk about what are the different outcomes of the SCOR model. So SCOR. SCOR stands for Supply Chain Operations Reference, which is a long form of SCOR model. And it is a process reference model, which was developed by Supply Chain Council in 1996. And it is referred as a cross-industry standard diagnostic tool for supply chain management. Now, what are the characteristics of SCOR model? So SCOR model is helping to standardize the processes, and it creates a measurable way to track results. It works across industries using common definitions that applies to any supply chain process. Using the SCOR model, businesses can judge how, businesses can know how advanced or mature a supply chain process is and how well it is aligned to a business objective. The SCOR model helps to integrate business concepts through measurement, then benchmarking, and then process re-engineering into the entire framework. The SCOR model uses standardized metrics so that organizations can compare their transportation, assets, and also regulatory compliance, which are required in a supply chain management. Now, the second process is source. Now, source describes sourcing infrastructure for material acquisition. It describes how to manage inventory, how to manage supplier network, how to manage supplier agreements, and also supplier performance. It also discusses on how to handle supplier payments and when to receive, when to verify, and when to transfer the products. So basically, this process involves identification and selection of suppliers, negotiation of contracts, placing orders on suppliers. It includes multiple activities like supplier selection, purchasing, procurement, and also supplier relationship management. So source is what we have seen. Now the third process is MEC. This process involves transforming raw material into finished goods, and it includes activities like production planning, production scheduling, and quality control. So manufacturing and production are the aspects of this step. In the manufacturing process, there are multiple manufacturing environments which are also considered here, like make to order, make to stock, engineer to order. So it also includes managing the production network, production equipments and facilities, and also the transportation aspects of the production. Now the next process is deliver. Now what is deliver? So deliver, basically this process involves transporting finished goods to a customer, and it includes multiple activities like transportation planning, defining routes, defining delivery schedules. So delivery includes also order management, warehousing, and it includes receiving orders from customers and invoicing them once product has been received. Now the next process is return. Now we all know that if there is a defective product that is shipped to customer, then there is basically a return. So the return component involves handling receiving items and managing various types of reverse logistics. Usually this process involves managing the return of defective or excess products, and it also includes activities like processing returns and reverse logistics aspects. The last process is enable, which is recently added in the SCOR model, and this includes processes which are associated with supply chain management, such as different business rules, facilities performance, data resources, contracts, compliance, and also risk management. And since it is recently added, I would say it is, one can also refer it as a support component of the SCOR model. Now we have seen that there are multiple processes, and these are simply interlinking to supply chain management flow. So whatever flow we have seen our previous topic, let's see this on the slide once again. So in this, you can see the source part is considered as a procurement or sourcing part, where supplier is involved in the source. Then make part is basically manufacturing, company is involved into the make part. In deliver part, you can see warehousing, transportation, and logistics comes into the picture. And in return part, again logistics and also some return activities are into a picture. Now plan plays a major role, which includes planning of resources, planning of labor, planning of transportation. So plan is across the supply chain process. So plan stands for basically a process which is guided by the management team of a supply chain function.